I want you to think of someone you know. How different are you? You might be different ages or a different sex, or they might be fatter than you, or you might get more mosquito bites when you both go on holiday. And in a natural population, the differences that exist between one animal and another is called individual variation. My name's Carly. I'm a first-year PhD student at the University of Sheffield, and for my research, I've got access to over 150 semi-captive Asian elephants living across Myanmar. And Myanmar's home to the largest captive population of Asian elephants in the world, with over 2,500 of them working in the logging industry. And they work in logging camps during the day, but at night they're free to forage in the surrounding forests and to interact with wild elephants. But Asian elephants are endangered. Globally, they're declining, and low fertility and survival rates mean that the working population isn't currently self-sustaining, and it's necessary to capture wild elephants to support the working population and meet global export demands for timber. And parasites living inside of these elephants play a key role in their low fertility and survival, as they cause disease and death throughout the working population. But what has this got to do with individual variation? Well, do you react in exactly the same way to an infection as a baby would, or your partner, or your granddad? What makes you all different, and how does this affect how susceptible and tolerant you are to that infection? To find out how and why individual elephants respond differently to parasitic infection, I'm comparing variation in their age, sex, reproduction, body condition, and stress levels to monthly changes in their internal parasite abundance and diversity. And so far, I've looked through over 100 kilos of elephant dung to do this, counting and identifying parasite eggs and larvae. And you can imagine some of the nicknames I've got from the local guys out there while I've been doing it. Dungball lady. And already, I've found huge individual variation in their parasite abundance, with some elephants having massive numbers of internal parasites and others having none at all. And this is linked to age, with the youngest elephants having the biggest burdens. And by finding out which elephants are most at risk of infection, who reacts badly to it, and if this happens at certain times in their lives and reproductive cycles, I'll be able to help improve the working population's fertility and survival. By creating targeted treatment schedules, by knowing how best to manage infection during reproduction, or who to monitor closely in periods of heavy stress, like heavy workloads. And I'll also get a better understanding as to why parasites generally seem to prefer a few specific hosts in any given animal population, like us. So if you do happen to be one of those people that gets eaten alive by mosquitoes when you're on holiday and no one else does, not only am I one of you, but I'll also be able to give you an idea of what specifically makes you so tasty. Thanks very much.